Hey everybody, hope you're doing well. We're gonna go listen to some Alison Krauss and Union Station. I've said it before, I'll say it again. Alison Krauss has the prettiest voice I can even imagine. It is just, it's like mother's milk. It's just so, so perfect. The way on this particular song, the song's called Maybe, and the way on this particular song, Dan Timinsky's backing harmonies meld together with Alison's voice is, it's perfect. It's musical heaven. It really is. That's all I gotta say. Here, let's check it out.
Yesterday, the odds were stacked in favor of my expectations. Flying above the rest, never falling from the nest. Tuesday came and went, and now I'm in a little situation. Maybe it's for the best. Maybe I can stand alone. Maybe I'm strong as stone, even though the brood has flown. Maybe he'll fly. Sort the whole thing out. Tell me that I'm smart enough to deal with all the information spinning inside my head. Every word he ever said. Maybe I can still.
Even though the bird has flown, maybe he'll fly on more.
Now, I've been fortunate enough to see Alison Krauss in Union Station a couple of times live, and they bring it every night. I don't know if I've ever heard any kind of story or tale of that group having an off night. They strive for musical perfection and generally achieve musical greatness every night. It's an old football saying: strive for perfection and accept greatness. And God, I mean, that voice. Oh my God. And yet it's, you know, it's had its flashes in the mainstream public, you know, with songs like, you know, Man of Constant Sorrow and the duet she did with Brad Paisley that I cannot think of to save my life right now. And so, you know, she's sung at the White House. She's sung on national television. She's sung everywhere, really. I mean, her recordings with Robert Plant, you know, what, won 5 Grammys, I think. You know, and she is one of the most highly decorated artists in Grammy music history, or, you know, Grammy Awards history. And yet it is, you know, it's a situation where, unfortunately, not as many people are open to listening to music outside of their comfort zone. You know, you don't necessarily hear too much about people who are into club and house music listening to bluegrass. You just don't. You know, European thrash metal bands and, you know, hardcore metal band fans aren't listening to country music, typically. I'm not saying there aren't some out there. People out there do have varied tastes, but generally, most people stick within their bubble of musical taste. And so they don't venture outside as much. Yeah, maybe the occasional song, you know, oh, my dad used to listen to that. My mom used to listen to that. I love that stuff. But I won't tell any of my friends because, God forbid, I be an individual. So I don't think I've seen too many reaction channels pull up Alison Krauss. And I can't get it. I just don't understand it. It does not ring to me. I mean, there are reaction channels out there who do, you know, like, Female Fridays, and they highlight, you know, these metal singing goddesses of or classic rock, you know, vocalists, you know, even disco vocalists. But for some reason, they don't hit the queen of bluegrass. And you know, spread your wings a little bit, people. That's all I'm saying. I'm not criticizing any of you. I'm just saying, there's more out there. And, you know, I remember recently everybody made a big deal about Beyonce winning more Grammy Awards than any other artist in history. And I'm like, who did she pass? She passed Quincy Jones and Alison Krauss. Those are the two people she passed. She got Quincy Jones, Alison Krauss, Beyonce. Top three, basically. And yet, everybody's, you know, all in the, oh my God, you know, Beyonce won more than anybody else. And again, all the credit to her. She made a success of herself. Again, you gotta sit back and go, well, yeah, who did she pass to get there? Who was there before her? Alison Krauss didn't get the fanfare that Beyonce's gotten. Why? Popularity contest. Popularity in the mainstream. What you see on the news, what you see in the press, what you see blasted out amongst your, you know, Instagram feed and your Facebook, you know, page. Again, all this wasn't a thing when Alison Krauss topped Quincy Jones or equaled Quincy Jones. Why? Social media wasn't as big. The push by the record labels wasn't as huge because she's just a bluegrass artist. Yeah, it doesn't matter that she's the bluegrass artist that is the guidestone for what the entire genre does. Nah, doesn't matter, you know. As talented as Beyonce is, there are thousands and thousands of pop female vocalists out there. Whether you're talking about Shakira or, you know, Olivia Rodrigo, or any number of others, thousands and thousands of very popular pop and dance artists out there. I'm not saying they're better than Beyonce. I'm just saying there's 1,000 copies. Hasn't been anybody that's really followed in Allison's footsteps. I mean, there are artists who follow her. Absolutely. There are plenty of bluegrass artists out there. You never hear them on the radio unless you're looking for them. So anyway, gone off on a tangent again. I apologize. Thanks for watching. Appreciate y'all. Please feel free to leave a comment in the comment section below. We can talk about it further. And y'all take care.